Using Spike Lee's latest achievement, Da Five Bloods, we look at the trademarks that make him one of the most iconic voices in the world of filmmaking. Okay, you know this already, but Spike Lee doesn't make films. He makes joints. He said that the word joint represents the ingredients of whatever subject matter he's exploring in a film, and the connecting tissue is that it's coming through him. In other words, when you're watching a joint, you're getting a unique experience that only Spike Lee can deliver. Spike Lee is famous for his iconic double dolly shot. As the name suggests, this is done by pulling two connecting platforms on a single track, a camera on one platform and an actor on the other. Creating the illusion of gliding, the double dolly can imply that a character is being pulled towards destiny, or that they're experiencing a surreal moment. Rarely settling for two close-ups in a wide, Lee's camera direction is full of immersive, creative shots and movements. These include Dutch angles, which often imply a world is off balance, lower shots to display a sense of control, and higher ones for a lack of control. While these are very cool, reliable shots, let's talk about one Spike is really known for. Spike Lee's films often include shots where his characters look directly at the fourth wall. Da Five Bloods has quite a few of these shots too, including one with a performance that you'll have to see to believe.
I will choose when and how I die.
Whenever the characters do this, they aren't looking at the camera. They're looking at you. The direct eye contact is one of the many ways Spike allows his viewers to connect to the characters on a personal level.
I consider myself normal, whatever that means. Some people call me a freak. I hate that word. I don't believe in it. Better yet, I don't believe in labels.
As a celebrated documentarian, Spike often likes to include archived video and photos into his films.
My kaisers won't let me go shoot my brother or some darker people or some poor hungry people in the mud for big powerful America and shoot them for what?
Da Five Bloods, for example, contains several clips from people speaking out on the Vietnam War and numerous stark reminders of what it cost for everyone involved.
I know all about me, Lai.
And you, G.I., murder, killer, up in the Centurion, and babies.
This establishes that what the viewer is watching has substantial ties to the real world and helps understand what's different as well as similar about a previous zeitgeist. A major aesthetic trademark of Spike Lee's work is highly saturated colors that pop in every single frame, as well as the occasional filmy grain for added grit. This creates a vibrant, stimulating atmosphere that you simply can't look away from. He also makes frequent use of warm and cold color filters, whether it's to allude to a scene's overall tone or to better sell a POV shot. No matter what kind of story Spike tells, it's always done in bold, engaging, and sometimes unexpected ways. This might be a lone color sequence in the otherwise black and white She's Gotta Have It, or a standalone musical number in School Days. In Da Five Bloods' case, Lee provides a remarkable sense of time by making every Vietnam flashback grainy, 4x3, and authentically vintage. This provides a raw, cerebral experience of how the characters themselves likely remember the war, as well as those left behind. Sure, putting 1975 stamp at the bottom of the screen might get the job done, but where's the spirit in that? If you're a real Spike Lee fan, you'll probably notice a few familiar faces in Da Five Bloods.
Bloods.
You got a bond.
What about my people?
This is my daughter.
Spike Lee's scripts are often character-driven and are always full of energetic dialogue and crackling wit.
It's not gonna work. What's not gonna work, no?
You and me.
You and me? What about me and you?
We do what we say, when we say it. No questions asked. Understood?
Overstood.
My name's Bennett. I ain't even in it.
We plead innocent to all charges, claims, accusations, allegations, and associations connected to the Klansmen in the Oval Office. So help me God.
On top of that, you'll often notice that Lee's films contain a meticulous use of repetition, inversion, and rhyming.
Our blood don't die, we just multiply.
Yeah, yeah.
Soon to be fine.
And then there are two words that Spike really likes to include in his scripts.
Wake up!
You can always expect to hear someone say, wake up, at least once in a Spike Lee joint.
Negroes better wake the fuck up with the quickness, man.
No.
Brady, wake up.
What?
No, Spike isn't afraid his film put you to sleep.
You had a little problem waking up this morning, didn't you?
Oh, please, baby, I get up with the roosters. I had an early audition.
Wake up represents looking at what's going on around you and standing up for the greater good.
Wake up!
Like most tenured film professors, Lee has a vast knowledge of renowned cinema and loves paying homage to the classics. The Five Bloods keeps this tradition alive and well, with several allusions to iconic pieces of film history.
Madness. Madness.
Where are your official badges?
We don't need no stinking official badge.
What is your name?
Hedy. Like Hedy Lamarr. Old-time Hollywood star.
You like me! You like me!
There's no place like home. There's no place like home.
And if we really keep our eyes peeled, you may even catch something from his own classic joints.
Ain't no problems of mine.
Spike Lee's work often takes a complex look at one of many societal issues, such as the tension that occurs between races as well as within one.
The word is excuse me.
Uh-uh. It's not real.
We're just taking a bus to Washington, D.C.
LAPD, huh?
That's right.
Well, I hate to break it to you, Rivers, but this is Knoxville, son.
I just thought that.
Yeah, I know what you thought.
In Da Five Bloods, Lee addresses the exploitation and unique struggles of African-American soldiers in the Vietnam War, as well as other wars.
Black GI, Negroes are only 11% of the U.S. population, but among troops here in Vietnam, you are 32%. Black GI, is it fair to serve more than the white Americans that sent you here?
We fought in an immoral war that wasn't ours.
For rights!
For rights we didn't have.
Like his other work, Spike covers this important issue with the same unmatchable insight, thoughtfulness, and finesse that can only be found in a Spike Lee joint. Did we miss something? Let us know in the comments.
Right on.